Hello everyone, in last lecture we have discussed the block diagram of electrical drives. In the block diagram of electrical drives having a five main blocks that are first source, second power modulator or power converter, third electrical motors, fourth mechanical load and fifth that is controller. That is control unit and sensing units. That are our five main blocks of electrical drives. Now we have to discuss the wall part of electrical drives. So let us start first source may be AC supply or DC supply. AC supply single phase or three phase AC source. Source means input to the power modulators. That is given by source. Very low power drives are generally fed from single phase sources. A single phase source is 230 volt 50 hertz. The rest of the drives are powered from a three phase sources. A three phase source is 415 volt 50 hertz. Low and medium power motors are fed from 400 volt supply. For higher rating motors may be rated at 3.3 kV, 6.6 kV and 11 kVs. And some drives are also powered by batteries. So that are the sources of electrical drives. Now power modulators. Power modulator is a most important part of the electrical drives. It is also called as a power converter. It converts the electrical energy from source to the motor as per the requirement by the load. So power modulator is also called as a power converter. Power modulator can be classified in three ways. First, that is converter. Second, variable impedance. Third, switching circuits. A converter may be also classified as a AC to DC converter. It is also called as a rectifier. Then AC voltage regulator. It is also called as a AC to AC converter. Then DC to DC converter. It is also called as a chopper. Then DC to AC converter. It is also called as a inverter and cyclo converter. So that are the converter that can be used in power modulators. The converters are AC to DC converter, AC to AC converter, DC to DC converter, DC to AC converter and cyclo converters. Now, first we have to study the function of power modulators. What kind of function of power modulators? The power modulators modulates the flow of power from source to motor in such a manner that motor is imported speed torque characteristics required by the load. That means what? It modulates the flow of power from source to motor. Then during transient operation such as a starting, braking and speed reversal, it restricts source and motor current within permissible value. Because during transient operation, starting, braking, speed reversal, high current will be drawn from the source. So it will make overload and also it can cause a voltage drop, voltage drip. So power modulator modulates the flow of power from source to motor during the transient operation. Now it converts electrical energy of the source in the form suitable to the motor. That means what? If the source is DC and motor is an induction motor, we know that induction motor is an AC motor. So the power modulator is DC to AC converter. That is also called as an inverter. So it converts the electrical energy as per requirement by the motor. Select the mode of operation of the motor. Power modulator can select the mode of operation like motoring or braking. Control for power modulator are built in control unit, which usually operate at lower voltage and lower power level. Sensing of drive parameters such as a motor current speed may be required either for protection or for closed loop operation, that is a control unit and sensing unit in power modulators. Now we have to discuss the converter. A converter means what? It converts electrical energy of the source in the form suitable to the motors. So we know that a power source may be two types. First, that is fixed voltage, fixed frequency AC, and second, that is fixed voltage DC. That is two power source, we know that. Now, if we have to control the DC motor, then we have to require a variable DC voltage. If we have to control a DC motor speed, then we have require a variable DC voltage. And if we have to control the AC motor, then we require either variable voltage and fixed frequency or variable voltage and variable frequency. So if we have to control AC motor, then we require two kind of voltage, variable voltage frequency and variable voltage and variable frequency. Now we have to discuss the first converter, that is AC to DC converter. It is also called as a rectifier. We know that rectifier having a two types, uncontrolled rectifier and controlled rectifier. And in uncontrolled rectifier, we have to use diode. So we have called diode uncontrolled rectifier. Input to the diode uncontrolled rectifier, that is fixed voltage, single or three phase AC supply. The output to the rectifier, that is fixed voltage DC. We know that. Then second type is thyristor control rectifier. The input to the control rectifier is fixed voltage, single phase or three phase AC supply, and output to the thyristor control rectifier, that is variable voltage DC. Because we know that a thyristor having a three terminal, so we can get a variable voltage at output side. So that is a AC to DC converter. Another way we have to get this variable DC voltage, we can get another way by this way: fixed voltage, single phase or three phase AC, that is given to the transformer with tap windings. The output to the transformer is variable voltage AC, because we know that transformer tapping, we can vary, then the output voltage is vary. So variable voltage AC at the output, and that is given to the diode rectifier. So it will give variable voltage DC. So in this way also we can get a variable DC from fixed voltage AC. And another way, if we have to get a variable DC, then fixed voltage single phase or three phase AC supply, that is given to the diode rectifier, and then output is fixed voltage DC. Then this fixed voltage DC is again given to the chopper. Chopper is a device that can be used to convert fixed voltage into variable voltage DC. So in this way also we can get a variable DC voltage from the fixed single phase or three phase AC supply. So our main purpose is to get a variable voltage, to control the speed. Okay. Now next converter, that is AC voltage controller. AC voltage controller is also called as a AC to AC converter. AC voltage controller means it is a auto transformer fixed turn ratio. If input is fixed voltage single phase or three phase AC, then the output is lower fixed voltage AC. That is the AC to AC converter. Now AC to AC converter, another way we can take a transformer with a tap winding. Input to the transformer tap winding is fixed voltage single or three phase AC. then output is variable voltage AC, because we know that when we vary the windings of transformer, the AC supply is also vary. Another way, a thyristor voltage controller. The input to the thyristor voltage controller is a fixed voltage single phase or three phase AC supply, and output of the thyristor voltage controller is variable voltage AC. So that is a AC to AC converter. Now next, that is DC to DC converter. It is also called as a chopper, semiconductor chopper. The input to the chopper, that is a fixed voltage DC, and output to the chopper, that is a variable voltage DC. So chopper is a device that can be used to convert fixed voltage DC into variable voltage DC. Next, that is DC to AC converter. It is also called as a inverter. So step wave semiconductor inverter. The semiconductor inverter input is fixed voltage DC. Input here is DC. Then we can get variable frequency fixed voltage AC. At the output side, we can get variable frequency fixed voltage AC. Now, if we use PWM semiconductor inverter, then from fixed voltage DC, we can get variable frequency and variable voltage AC. So we can get a variable frequency, also variable voltage AC at the output side. So that is a DC to AC converter or inverters. Now next, that is cyclo converter. Cyclo, the word cyclo means a frequency, and converter, that means to convert frequency at one side to the another side. Cyclo converter is a device that can be used to convert the frequency at input side to the output side. So you can change the frequency, fixed voltage, fixed frequency, AC voltage. The output side, you can get variable voltage and also a variable frequency AC voltage. So that is a cyclo converter. Now we have to discuss the second most important part of electrical drives, that is electrical motor. Electrical motor is a device that can convert electrical energy into the mechanical energy at the load side. So in the electric motor, we have to use different kind of electrical motors. The motors are DC motors, AC motors, synchronous motors, and special motors. In the DC motor, we have to discuss the different types of DC motors, that is shunt motor, series motor, compound and permanent magnet DC motors. In AC motor, we know that squirrel cage induction motor, slip ring or wound rotor induction motor, linear motor, that are the AC induction motors. Then synchronous motor having two types, that is wound field and permanent magnet motor. A special motor, that is brushless DC motor, that means BLDC motors. Then stepper motors, switch reluctance motor, and also we can add a servo motors also. So that are the special motors that can be used in electrical drive systems. So that are the electrical motor. Now, electrical motor, due to the presence of commutators and brushes, DC motor have a number of disadvantages as compared to the AC motor. DC motor having a commutator and brushes, so it having some kind of frictions problem. So DC motor having some kind of disadvantage compared to the AC motors. Higher cost, volume need for frequent maintenance, speed, power rating unsuitable for the explosive environment. That are the parameters of selection of electrical motors. Now, a second most part is control units. A control unit is a part of controller. It depends on power modulator. Control unit is mainly depend on power modulators. The control units controls the power modulator, which operate at small voltage and power level. The control unit also operates the power modulator as desired, because control unit give a signal to the power modulator to operate. It also generates the commands for the protection of power modulators and motors. An input command signal which adjusts the operating point of the drive from the input to the control units. Many types of firing circuits and microcontroller are the control units. We can use some kind of firing circuit, that means to turn on any kind of power semiconductor device, we have to use controller units as a microcontroller or firing circuits that can give some pulses to the power semiconductor device. That is a control units, that is a function of control units. Next, that is sensing units. It senses the certain drive parameters like motor current, speed, torque also. It mainly require either for protection or for closed loop operation. It is a unit of various sensors of speed and torque of the load. Sensing units. A sensing unit can be used as a speed sensing, torque sensing, position sensing, current sensing and voltage sensing and temperature sensing. For speed sensing, we can use a instrument like tachometers. We know that tachometer is a device that can be used to measure the speed. Anemometers is a device that can be used for measure the wind speed. Then speedometers that can be used to measure the speed and velocity both. Then torque sensing, a magnetoelastic torque sensor is a device that can be used to measure the torque. In the position sensor, we can use GPS, vibrometer, rotary encoders, and current and voltage sensings from lines from motors terminals. Then temperature sensing, we can use a thermistor to measure the temperatures. So that are the sensing unit that can be used in electrical drives. Now, choice of electrical drives. How we can select the electrical drives? We can select electrical drive as per our requirement. So that having some points, like first, it can depend on steady state operation requirement. The steady state operation like natures of speed torque characteristics, speed regulation, speed range, efficiency, duty cycle, quadrant of operation, speed fluctuation, if any, transient operation, value of acceleration, deceleration, starting, braking, reversing performance, that are the transient operation. Depending on transient operation, we can also select the electrical drives. Requirement related to the source, as per source, type of source, its capacity, magnitude of voltage fluctuation, power factor, harmonic, and their effect on other loads ability to accept a regenerated power. It is also depend on this. Capacity and running cost, maintenance need and life. That is another most important for the choice of electrical drives. Space and weight restriction, if any. Then environmental and location. And last, that is reliability. That are the parameters that can be used for the choice or selection of electrical drives. So that is the first introduction of electrical drives. Okay, thank you.